The House of Michelle, Hidden Mountain, and then I'm building my tiny shelter to survive in my farm here. Mountains of Appalachia. That's my house so far. Built by hand. Nothing fancy yet, but who knows? Things have a way of getting fancy. Not that that matters. From the view. My son's house in the background. It's our land. 45 acres here. Paid for by the grace of Yahweh. Well, a few days ago, I had, I guess what you would call a vision. I was awake, so it wasn't a dream. And I only saw it in my mind, but you know, I didn't hear a voice other than that of my own mind, but it seemed so clear and so full in answering my questions that I can't really claim it was from my own brain. I think I would be lying. But whether it's true from Yahweh or not, only time will tell. Walking down to my neighbor's house to get online because totally offline here. Nor do I want to be. Only solar and waterfront creek. There's the creek. Go look at the creek. Anyways, in the vision, I'll call it, I've been praying and doing a lot of research, reading the prophets very slowly, chronologically, of the Old Testament, one by one as they happened. And I've been into the flat earth realization. I'm on to the moon hoax. ever since basically the beginning, when Matt Powerland put out his first bid, I was drawn to it by the Holy Spirit early on. I think I was one of the first people that actually caught on to what he was saying. Not by any worthiness of my own or anything, it just was like that. The Holy Spirit, can't even remember why or how I found it. But back then it was only Dubay and Eric Dubay and Mark and Matt Powerland. And they both The other two seem ridiculous. Right off the bat. But, and Matt, you know, he's like full of himself, but I think Yahweh kind of gave him a vision. Even though he is very self-focused, he seems to be right so far in a lot of things that other people just aren't getting. Strangely enough. Anyways, I'm not gonna have time to finish the full vision. I'm gonna run out of minutes here, but I saw that the firmament above is sapphire because it says so in the word. And that's why the sky is blue. Pretty straightforward. Also, I think it's the bottom color of the rainbow, if I'm not mistaken. And there's a rainbow around the glory of Yahweh in the heaven around his throne. And so the bottom part of that rainbow could be blue, sapphire. And his throne, the earth is his footstool, and his throne is upon the cherubim, which are in the second, which stand upon the second firmament. And that is where the chariot of Yahweh is on this, resting upon the firmament. And from everything I could tell, that was told to me in that moment, and in my study of the Hebrew, because I am a student of the Hebrew and the ancient Hebrew for many a year now, that the word north is not as we understand it. And if we truly align a true flat map, which we're just now coming to, based on Jerusalem as center instead of London and places east or west, then prophecy would all be, this is what I don't get, why nobody else has done any work in this direction. Seems strange. That prophecy would all be based on the true flat earth map, and east and west and north and south would be totally different than what we think. And the word north in Hebrew is not our sense of north. It's not like a direction necessarily. For instance, it's often said in that Yahweh dwelleth in the sides of the north. So it makes it sound more like the north is a place, not a direction. And what we have instead is more of a east-west and south directions relative to Jerusalem. And north is potentially where the center, where the pole is. And that, I've always thought now for some time that the moon and the sun are projections somehow upon the firmament, that they are not necessarily bodies. The word says they are lights in the firmament. Which firmament? I don't know. It could be the earth, and they're projected up onto the sapphire sky. Or it could be that